can see we're talking about educational aspects. For a professional, it's very important to have a professional degree, regardless of the level. In the global market, there is a mix that every job looks for, the mix of education and experience. So if you have the right experience, then you need to understand that with a basic degree, you will succeed. And I'm talking about industrial world. In the industrial world, people in the global scenario, in Europe, in North America, in South America, anywhere in the world where I have gone, nobody will ask you for very high advanced degrees. They're not looking for scholars. And I'm talking about industrial, don't take me wrong. In the industrial world, they're looking for a basic degree, undergrad degree, and your relevant experience towards your degree program. And after that, okay? If you have proven that you are the right person for them, they're not looking for PhDs, they're not looking for MPhils, they're not looking for masters. You must have a degree, professional undergrad degree, with 4 or 5 years of good experience. You are into the global market. Now, but if you are into the market of academia, if you are in the academia market, if you are in the research and development market, you must have advanced education degree. There's no way about that. So you need to set, like I said, you need to have your mindset. Which way you want to go? Are you going to be an academia leadership leader? Then you must have a master degree, a PhD, a postdoc, and relevant experience then on the top of it. If you are going to industry, and I am from the industry side, so my focus will be more on that area. So in that area, your grad degree, or in some cases in a master degree, for example, in a research and development program, an advanced degree is always taken as respectful than a undergrad degree. But overall, like I said, 90% of my experience in the world, but 26 years of the service that I have given, an undergrad degree with right experience will get you ways. Okay? Now, people always ask me this question wherever I go. I am in Australia, I came from Pakistan, I want to go for a better job, what should I do? So I tell them that you first of all make sure that what is the market demand? People बैठे होते हैं साउथ अफ्रीका में और दे आर आस्किंग फॉर मैंने बीआरसी करनी है मैंने बीआरसी जीएस करनी है ठीक है दे नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड कि किस मार्केट में मौजूद है आप क्या वो मार्केट डिमांड करती है अगर वो मार्केट डिमांड नहीं करती है तो आपको उस सर्टिफिकेट की जरूरत नहीं है यू मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड कि आप किस इंडस्ट्री में हो आप किस कंपनी में हो उसकी डिमांड क्या है उसकी मार्केटिंग की डिमांड क्या है उसकी सेल्स की डिमांड क्या है और वो किन मार्केट्स को हिट करती है सो आई ऑलवेज यूज टू से योर सर्टिफिकेट हैज टू बी फॉर द विल ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन नॉट फॉर द वॉल ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सो आप अपनी कंपनी के रिसोर्सेज को बर्न नहीं करें आप अपने रिसोर्सेज को बर्न नहीं करें डू नॉट मेक ए सीवी फुल ऑफ द सर्टिफिकेट्स व्हिच इज नॉट मेंट फॉर एनीथिंग डू द सर्टिफिकेशन राइट सर्टिफिकेशन फॉर द राइट जॉब and something which creates a business or opens the door for your organization. Then that certificate or that standard will help you. Okay. I'll give you a few more examples later in the discussion. I talked about advanced degrees in academia versus industrial needs. Right mixture. You need to understand there was time when we finished our degrees, we were told that if you want to be the leader of an organization or a food organization, you must combine yourself with a professional degree plus a business degree. So we see in 90s and early 2000s in the global market, a lot of people became the food leaders who they had the mix of professional degree plus a business degree. I myself even got into that and to some extent I got success. But things are moving to a next level, and I will discuss in the next slides. I have seen not only the business degree now, Now the IT and data informative system degree on the top of a food science is becoming very successful in the world. Under the COVID situations, under the new scenario that the whole world is now going through, under the artificial intelligence situation, we need to start understanding is a combination of IT with the professional degree that we have would help or not. And I have put in the last that what is the need and challenge for our academia and for our people who they are capability builders. Do we need to have something as an informative IT course in our undergrad level or at the grad level so that people become a bit savvy before they go to the field? Data analysis has become a huge question now and people are spending a lot of time and efforts. So companies would be definitely looking for a mix of professionals who they have technical degrees plus they have the IT background. Legal on the top, and I will give an example. There's a huge company in Canada, Loblaws International. The person who is heading the quality of Loblaws right now, that company is competitor of Walmart International. That person does not have a food science degree. That person has a legal degree. She is a lawyer, and she is a reputable corporate lawyer, and she has done HACCP and BLC, and all those things, and JFSI, and this is where the rubber has hit the ground. The company thought that they are in a better hand if a lawyer is coming ahead. So, as food professional, I'm thinking, why not a food science person has also the understanding of the legal system or the corporate legal system or regulatory system to the next level? We have regulatory affairs, but do we know that in case of a discrepancy, in case of a contingency between them and the legal system of that country, is a food scientist ready to take the challenge as a lawyer took the challenge? I'm not diminishing or disrespecting the profession of the law, but I'm trying to say, is there space that we can get? Like I said about IT and artificial intelligence, like the business and the food. So let's open our mind to those areas. On the top, degree only tells that you are trainable. One of my teachers in States told me that your degree tells me only one thing, that I can train you. Rest is your capability, if you are capable to work with it or not. So keep that in your mind. Putting certificates will not get you spaces. I'm telling you, I'm running a global show of 16 companies in the world, and I will not hire a person with 10 pages of CV without a capability and income. So don't bulk your CV. Nowadays, CV is only one page with 10 to 20 bullet points. If you cannot take first 15 seconds of an executive to get attracted to your CV, we are losing it. So do not do the courses which are irrelevant and just for the having a certificate, and do not study something which is not relevant to your path which you want. Okay? It doesn't mean that education is not worth it and valuable. I'm saying create the value of the degree that you have.